So let's take a look at our first named distribution, that being the binomial probability distribution. And that's what this next several videos will be discussing. So like usual, let's take a quick look at the learning objectives. First of all, we want to be able to identify an experiment as being binomial or not. We will talk a great deal about assumptions. Every process that we use has certain assumptions to them, and the binomial is no different. We will list out each assumption. And using those assumptions, that's what we will use to be able to identify whether a particular experiment will qualify as a binomial. We want to compute the probabilities associated with the events of a binomial distribution, and I want to be able to find the mean, variance, and standard deviation of a binomial random variable. So first of all, like I mentioned earlier, the binomial distribution is actually our first named distribution. And there's going to be several more. We'll have a bunch of distributions we'll take a look at. Something that's really important for you to grasp is this: why is it that probability distributions are so important? So let me ask a real simple question here. What is the probability of observing a head when you flip a coin? What is that probability? Right away, you're going to say, well, gosh, that's 1/2. And that's true under certain assumptions. And the assumption here is that this coin that I'm talking about is a fair coin. Now, the only way that you could tell me that that probability is 1/2 is if you happen to know the probability distribution for flipping a single coin, which you knew. You didn't know it because of this course. It's almost like you were born with that information. Well, the born thing may be just a little bit of exaggeration. But the point is, you all know that if you flip a coin, the probability of getting hit is 1/2. You kind of grew up with that idea. But that's because you know, again, the probability distribution. If I do this, probability of no heads is 1/2. Probability of 1/2 is 1/2. You actually know this. It's in your head. You don't think of it that way, but you know it. The only way you could, again, answer that question was if you knew this distribution. Whether you had a conscious knowledge of it or not, you cannot answer probability distribution questions without a probability distribution. You can't do it. Earlier, we looked at the probabilities, or different probabilities you'd observe when flipping 4 coins. Earlier than that, we flipped 3 coins. We established a probability distribution. Once we had the probability distribution, then we could start asking questions and start making probability statements. So that's why probability distributions are so important. They give us a way to find the probability of an event we are interested in. Again, probability distributions give us probabilities for events we are interested in. No distribution, no probability. It's really that simple. And since what we're leading to is making all kinds of decisions based on probabilities, then we must have a wide range of understanding of different types of probability distributions that will ultimately allow us to make those decisions.